This week's tutorial is how to get multiple birds in the frame sharp. So if you have three or four birds in the picture that you want to take, how do you make sure that they're all sharp? So if the birds are side by side and they're kind of lined up and you're shooting perpendicular to that line, they're all on the same plane, then it's going to be easy because your depth of field will pick up all of them. They'll all be within your limited amount of depth of field. That doesn't happen very often in bird photography. Line up one, two, three, right in a row, perpendicular to where we're going to take their picture, and that our distance from each bird is the same. We know that that doesn't happen very much. Most of the time, the birds are going to be staggered. They're going to be in a triangle pattern, or they're going to be one, two, three, back further. When that happens, the only way to get them all sharp is to stop down your aperture and go from f8 to f16 to f32 or somewhere in between so that you get more depth of field and those birds can all be sharp. And then the other thing to remember is that two ways you can check your depth of field. You can use the preview button, push this down, and it will close down the aperture to what I shot the picture at, and it will show me which birds are in focus and which aren't. Or you can look at the LCD on your camera and you can zoom in on each bird. That's a pretty good way to check too. If you reduce the amount of light that you have coming through the aperture, you're going to have to increase the ISO so that the sensor is more sensitive, or you're going to have a slower shutter speed so more light comes in and strikes the sensor. Now I know a lot of you are going to like this one because if you have a 100 to 400 millimeter lens, you're going to have more depth of field than if you're shooting with a 600 millimeter. The longer your telephoto length or the more power telephoto zoom you're using, the less depth of field you're going to have and the birds are going to be less sharp. So an optimal setup might be 100 to 400. Paying attention to the focal length that you're using can increase the sharpness of those multiple birds in the frame. The further you are away from the birds, the more depth of field you will have. So if I'm 60 feet away, I'm going to have more depth of field than if I'm 40 feet away or 30 feet away. So the closer you are, the less depth of field you have. The further away you are, the more depth of field you have. So shoot it, you know, pull up on the birds, but stay 60 feet away or 100 feet away. I took some pictures of a bunch of bald eagles feeding on a seal carcass morning, and I was 200 feet away. So just about whatever aperture I used, they were pretty sharp. Although with the 600 at f4, some of them weren't. Some of them were still a little bit soft. And then I shot some other pictures at about 70 feet away with the 600 millimeter lens eagles, and some of those at f4 and f5.6 are a little soft, whereas you get up to f11, f16, and they're pretty sharp. The ways to get all the birds sharp in a picture when you have multiple birds is stop down the aperture so that you get more depth of field, use a shorter telephoto lens so you have more depth of field, move away further from the birds so you have more depth of field, or just hope and pray that they're all nicely right next to each other and they're each the same distance away from you so they're within your depth of field. But getting all the birds sharp in an image is all about managing your depth of field. Make sure you watch your shutter speed, make sure you watch your ISO if you're going to stop down to F32 or F22 or something. Hey, if you enjoy what I'm doing, give me a like, share, and subscribe. I would really appreciate that. And remember, you can always learn more about bird photography by getting a copy of my book. It's available on Amazon as a trade paperback and as a Kindle. Or you can get a signed copy of the book from my website, timboyerphotography.com. If you already have a copy of my book and you've been watching my tutorials, here's another way you can learn more about bird photography. In August this year, I'm doing a 5-day intensive bird photography workshop at Ocean Shores, Washington. We're going to spend about 5 or 6 hours in the field photographing each day and about 3 hours in the classroom setting learning the techniques, learning the background of why things work and how things work so you can get better pictures. Thanks a lot for watching. I will see you next week. Bye.